Again, please request all of you to mute yourself. We can start again.
Sure, Kamal, we can definitely start. So good morning to all the participants. We welcome you to this webinar. Kamal has already highlighted the ground rules. So very quickly, I'll reiterate them. So people who are logging in from their mobile phones, please do not use video because you might have connectivity issues and you're not able to hear the session. For everybody else who's logged in from the you can switch on your videos as per convenience. If you have any questions during the session, please put them on the chat box. Our team will be looking at those questions. And as part of the Q&A session, which happen towards the end of it, we will pick up those questions for answers. Please have your pen and papers handy so that you can take notes for your response whenever you like. There will be some special offers towards the end of the session. So these will be available only for people who stay with us till the end of it. So that's like a carrot for everybody who's patient enough for the next 90 minutes. How we will go about doing the session is, so my name is Akhil. I'll be the host and facilitator for the session today. We'll start with the panel members' introduction, and then we'll jump onto the respective courses. So we'll cover one course at a time. And then towards the end of the session, we will have the Q&A round, right? So thank you all for joining us. I hope everybody is safe. I know it's a difficult period for all of us, 40 days of lockdown. We're all restricted to our homes, but I'm sure we're doing a lot. We're learning a lot. And obviously, let's build our understanding on some of these courses available for all of us, right? So this session is conceptualized and brought to you by Capit Solutions. Kamaljeet is the Managing Director for Capit Solutions, and we will also be talking about Capit as we move forward, right? So let's begin the session and let's understand who we are. So I'll first introduce all the panel members. So we will first have Kamaljeet Kaur. So Kamal, if you can have you saying hi to the team and also the slide so that people get to know you better. So Kamaljeet, so one thing which is very common between the panel members for today is they're all chartered accountants. We are all teachers and educationists at heart. We are all very talkative. So reach out to us through social media platforms, through LinkedIn, and we'll be happy to connect with all of you. So here we go. So Kamaljeet is a FCA and a CFE. She's a committee member of the PhD Chambers of Commerce and also the secretary of the Women's Club of the IIA. She's got 14 years of industry experience, and she's currently a trainer and provides consulting services in the field of digital forensics, fraud investigation across different kinds of organizations. So some of the organizations that she's worked with are CBI, State Bank of India, ICAI, and the Customs Authority. The next member that we have on the panel today is Shreyans. So Shreyans is also a chartered accountant and a company secretary. He's a rank holder in both of them. He's done his global MBA from EBS France, which is one of the top 50 ranked universities as per The Economist. He's got about 18 plus years of experience in different facets of finance and accounting. And the most close to his heart course is CPA. So he'll be talking about CPA as we move forward. The next panelist that we have is Sana. So Sana is our ACCA guru. She is the founder and president of the IIADC Women's Circle, and she's also the founder of Study Khazana. So education is what comes naturally to her. She's got 14 years of experience, and she's also a chartered accountant and company secretary, and has also done her DISA, which is Diploma in Information Systems Auditor. The next we have is me. My name is Akhil. I am also an educationist and teacher by heart. So I'm a CA rank holder, a silver medalist in MBA from IIFT. And I've also done my SEMA. I've got about 17 years of working experience, and I've worked with some of the biggest brands, for example, EY, Google, British Council, HSBC, and American Express. I'm also the founder for Hriday Foundation, and traveling and photography are two of my passions. When I'm not doing anything, this is where I spend most of my time with. Right. So that's the four panelist members that we have. We also have Manish with us, who's he says that he is very shy, so he did not want his picture and credentials up there. But he manages the communication, marketing and branding for Capitch. And he's been in the marketing and e-commerce space for about 14 years. So that's who we are. That's what we are. And now we will get into talking about the respective courses. Right. So Kamal, we'll start with you. So forensics, as I've heard, is the new buzzword, right? And recently, and in a very layman language, if I understand forensics right, so forensics is the study which gives you the early warning signals about company health, about employee behavior, and some of the other practices in the corporate world, right? So if you can help us understand CFE, Certified Fraud Examiner, in more detail, what are the benefits, who should do it, and how do you see this evolving in the next few years? Over to you, Kam.
Thanks, Akhil. So guys, I'll start with a very small example when it comes to the difference between fraud and error. Most of us who will be working in the corporate or who may have done their article check might have used official scanner and printer for the personal purpose. Do you really think it's a fraud? I'm sure most of us might say no. How can this be fraud? This is a very small thing, you know. What difference will it make if I take a small pen from the company or if I just use company scanner and printer for the personal purpose? But trust me, this is a fraud. And technically, in global language or in technical language, we call it asset misappropriation. You'll be amazed to know that as per survey, the asset misappropriation is the most frequently done fraud across world. The quantum may be very small. You might think it's such a small pen, 10 rupees pen or a 1 rupee printout I have taken. What difference will it make? Now that's where the difference between fraud and error arises. So the difference between fraud and error is simple: the malicious intention. When you don't know what you're doing is wrong and you do it, you call it error. But when you know what you're doing is wrong, you call it fraud. Fraud is something which occurs in every industry at very, very frequent rate. You may not have seen a lot of news in the market, but that doesn't mean the companies are not having frauds. Be it retail, be it company, the frauds are occurring at very, very high speed. And that is where it makes a lot of sense to think about the certification which enhances your skill set in fraud investigation. So very quickly, I'll throw some light on the certification, which is called Certified Fraud Examiner. In short, we call it CFE. So quick facts about CFE. CFE is a globally recognized certification. The official body is in United States of America, but it is globally recognized, including India. Once you have done CFE, you can work across industry. Bank, NBFC, Big Four, multinational company, Indian companies, companies like Amazon, Flipkart. So you name the industry, you name the company, and there is a requirement of CFE. Fraud is there today, fraud will be there tomorrow. So I don't see fraud is going out of fashion soon. And that is where if you enhance your skill set in fraud investigation, I think you have a very long-term career ahead. Quick facts. So this is a certification, not a degree. Anybody who's a graduate from any stream, it does not matter whether you're an account student or not. You have to be graduate from any stream and you have to have 24 months of relevant experience. Suppose you do not carry 2 years of relevant experience in the investigation, no problem. You can still appear for the exam. You will be clearing, you will get your certification, but you cannot call yourself member. In order to be a member, you have to finish your 24 month of relevant experience, which you can do afterwards as well. Exams are online on demand. Whenever you are ready, you can give the exam. Tentatively, it takes about 2-2.5 months time to prepare for the certification. Exams can be given from home as well. There are no center worldwide for the certification. It's an online, on-demand paper. multiple choice paper. Four sections is something where you have to clear. You get 30 days to finish those four sections. In each section, there are 100 questions. You have to score 75% each section in order to pass it. No negative marking. Now, the next question might be, what is the difficulty level? The difficulty level is moderate. It entirely depends whether you have conceptual clarity or not. So if you're conceptually clear, I don't see this exam as tough. There are no practical questions to be solved, no balance sheet, no P&L account to be made. It's more about understanding of the concept. It's a very interesting subject to study. I'm sure when you'll be studying CFE, hardly there'll be any day when you'll feel bored. It's like watching a thriller movie. And trust me, not only the academic, but the profile also is very interesting. Once you are done with CFE, you can think about upgrading your skill set more into the similar field, into digital fraud investigation. There are many certifications available for that, such as anti-money laundering, cybersecurity courses like CISA, CISM, and many more. So sky is the limit when it comes to the certification of CFE. So these were some quick facts for CFE from my end. If you have any question related to CFE, please feel free to put that in chat box. And post the session, we'll be happy to take those questions. So that's all about CFE from my end.
So Kamal, thank you. I think that was interesting insight about CFE. You've been doing trainings in a lot of corporates as well as banks and also some of the other boutique firms as well. So would you want to share some of your experiences in terms of the kind of audience and their experience they have, and at what stage in their career, understanding the need for forensics, they're picking up the certification of CFE?
Sure, Akhil. So I have been training people from various industries, various vertical at various stages of their career as well. I mean, I've trained people in CBI, Custom, Narco, Delhi Police, banks, multinational company, insurance company, and so on. Generally, people in these kind of training could be at junior level, mid-level, or very, very senior level. So I would not say this certification is only for senior level people. It is for across vertical, across hierarchies. Everybody can think about getting into this kind of profession. At the same time, at what level the company will be taking you or what will be your salary, it entirely depends on your current exposure and the company you are joining in. But then career path is very, very good when you think about it.
Yeah, and I think just to add from my corporate experience, if I talk about the Big Fours as well, so I think Big Fours are very actively getting into forensics. So this is a very niche and upcoming field, so to say. A lot of corporates, because of the scandals and scams that we have had in the past, I think they're also trying to set up internal teams or maybe hire forensic experts in kind of looking at the different elements of this field, right? So Kamal, as we talk about CFA, there are a couple of questions that has come in. So one is from Ekansh and the other is from PK. So they're asking that does internal audit experience or let's say a capital markets process associate get considered as relevant experience if they want to pursue CFA and also get the certification?
So guys, the relevant experience means the experience should be in the field of fraud investigation. However, they do take the experience of internal audit risk-based profile also as relevant. So entirely depends what was your profile. So if you're working in capital market and you are having some kind of exposure in finding the right security, or you may have come across any kind of security fraud and you have handled, it can definitely be considered as relevant. Internal audit experience is definitely considered relevant. Anyone in this audience, if you have internship experience, articleship experience, may also be considered as relevant.
Great. I think I'm sure this would motivate a lot of people, because getting a certification at the right start of their career would maybe add a feather to their cap. So the question that is there on the chat is, can we get brochures and more details around it? So I think towards the end of the session, we will share the email IDs and contact details of CAPEG. So anybody who's interested for any specific course, you can reach out to the team. and the team will be happy to share the relevant details with you and also maybe get a chance to talk to you, right? So thank you, Kamal. We'll circle back to you for the next course. I'll move on to Captain America. So Captain America is one of our favorite characters. I personally like him. And I'm sure we all have a fascination for United States of America. So while they've not been able to handle COVID very well, but the fascination still remains. So at this point in time, I would like to bring in Shreyans. So Shreyans, if you can walk us through one of the very popular courses amongst youngsters and also professionals is CPA. So if you can take walk us through the course curriculum, some of the benefits and the recent changes that have happened with reference to CPA. Over to you, Shreyans.
Thanks, Akhil, for the kind words. Well, Captain America is not fighting well with COVID, but no mistake, US still dominates the world economy. US has a GDP of $21 trillion, which is 1/4 of the world. If you talk about Fortune 500 companies, 25% of the Fortune 500 companies are from US itself. And I can go on as the list is long. But hey, who all want to work in a Fortune 500 company? Well, majority of you all. Well, then your choice to pursue CPA is leading you there. Confused? Let me explain. CPA, the acronym stands for Certified Public Accountant. It's the highest level of certification in public accounting awarded by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants, which in short we call it as AICPA. AICPA is the world's largest accounting body. Mind you, our Institute of Chartered Accountants of India is world's second largest accounting body. Now to draw the analogy of CPA in Indian context, you can refer CPA as equivalent to Chartered Accountancy course in India. And AICPA is equivalent to Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, that's ICAI. Now moving on, what does benefits a CPA provides if you are willing to take it on? Well, there are many. First, to start with, US CPA course is globally recognized. It's an advanced level credential which has become a global benchmark for accountants and financial professionals all throughout the world. Your CV gets highlighted with a globally recognized professional degree under your belt. It also provides a very high return on investment. Why so? First, this course can be completed in a comparatively short period of time, say 6 to 8 months, in comparison to CSA, which takes around 4 years, CWA, which again around 6-4 years. And secondly, earning potential after becoming CPA is quite high. That's why your return on investment for this course is significantly higher. Moving on to the benefits, CPA has a very high percentage in comparison to its peer competitive examination. It equips you with not just finance and accounting terms, but it gives you necessary skill set in order to climb higher in organizational hierarchy. And lastly, it opens the doors to work abroad because CPA is applicable for not just American companies, which are very large in numbers, but a CPA equips you with working in other international companies as well, because after pursuing CPA, you became an expert in US GAAP vis-a-vis IFRS as well. So you can see yourself the potential it opens for working in companies worldwide. Now that was about CPA and its benefits. Moving on to how to become CPA. Well, I'm sure you could be bogged down with the nuances which are coming out and which have already been discussed. But still, if you have any queries, feel free to put it in the chat box and we can discuss it on. So moving on with how to become CPA, well, there are 3 E's in becoming the roadmap to become a CPA. First one is education. Second one is obviously exam. And the third one is experience. I'll take you through all these 3 E's one by one, starting with education. Education, you can associate it with the eligibility criteria. Now in CPA, mind you, giving exam is one thing, but to become eligible to give an exam is itself a Herculean task. Now I'll try to demystify this task for you. The eligibility requirement varies state by state. State by state means in India, ICAI is a central body. Across India, ICAI is a rule decision-making body for Indian CS. But in CPS, the US has 55 states and every state has its own jurisdiction and it determines the rules and regulations for its own specific state. So you need to be very mindful while choosing the jurisdiction which you want to stay later on practice or stay or want to be a member of so that you become eligible for the CPA examination. But one thing which is majoritively common in all those 55 states is with respect to the basic eligibility requirement, which is to obtain 120 credit hours. Now, how to get those credit hours? Well, in US, the bachelor's degree is a 4 years. So you get 120 credit hours if you do a bachelor's degree of 4 years. In India, the bachelor's degree is of 3 years. So generally, Indian students get 90 credit hours with their bachelor. So you need to have some additional degree to cover those 120 credit hours. And that's a very important facet for eligibility. Now, there has been some amendments recently, which has been bogging students because people are coming to me and they're saying that I am able to get 120 credit hours, but still the states are not accepting our application. The reason being is there has been recent update. Now, the accounting boards are not just looking at 120 credit hours holistically, but they are also checking the credit hours under accounting and business head specifically. If you see your evaluation reports, you'll find that the credit hours are broken down into accounting heads, business heads, and other heads. So now your accounting and business heads also become crucial besides the holistic credit hours. And lastly, under this segment, there is an additional requirement of 30 credit hours by majority of accounting boards if you want to get a licensed CPA. Now, I have introduced a new term here, licensed CPA. There is a difference between a CPA and a licensed CPA, which I'll be covering in later on during the video. The CPA curriculum is divided into four parts, or you can say four examinations. First is financial accounting and reporting. Second one is auditing and attestation. Third one, regulation. And the fourth and final one, business environment and concepts. The CPA exam is a computer online based exam of 4 hours each. And the type of questions which you get is MCQs, which is 50% of your exam, and the rest 50% is task-based simulation or written communication. Now, where you can give exams? Now, the CPA exams can only be given at ProMetric centers. Now, the ProMetric centers are available in US. For India, you can say the nearby is Dubai and Japan. But there has been of late a silver lining in this category as well. Recently, the ProMetric centers have been opened in India. That well is a very, very, very important update for Indian students. But a point of caution to be noted here is that this has not become a permanent phenomenon yet. Only in June and September of this year, as of now, you can give examination in India. So if you want to plan your examination in India, schedule your exams, prepare your examination schedule accordingly so that you can give it in June and September. There are chances that due to COVID, it can get extended, but as of now, there has been no official communication. Now, when can you give exams during the year? The testing window for CPA is almost throughout the year, but it's divided into quarterly basis. The quarter starts from January itself. So every quarter, for the first 2 months of the quarter, you can give exams throughout those months. For the third quarter, you can give exam only in first 10 days of the third month of the quarter. So for example, for the first quarter, that is January to March, you can give exam entirely in January, entirely in February, but only first 10 days for the month of March. That's the end month of any quarter. Again, there has been a recent update in this. Due to COVID, many updates have come off late. The important update is that with effect from 1st July 2020, a continuous testing concept has been introduced, which means that now you can give examinations throughout the year. There is no such hindrance that in the third month of a quarter window opens for only 10 days. That has been done away with now. Now, the passing score for CPA is, the passing percentage, mind you, is very high in comparison to its peer examinations, say CA or other professional qualifications. And the passing score is 75 on a scale of 0 to 99. And that was about CPI examination pattern. That was the second E. Now moving to the last and final E, which is experience. Now if you remember, I talked about CPI and a licensed CPA differentiation. Now if you clear the exam, you became a CPA. But if you want to practice, you need a license. Similarly, we talk about CA. If you clear CA examination, you become a CA. But in order to practice, you need a certificate of practice from Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Similarly, if you want to do practice in CPA, you need a license. And for that, the third E comes into picture, which is experience. After clearing exam, you need to have some sort of experience in the domain of public accounting in order to be eligible to get CPA license. If you demonstrate that experience, you have to apply to the respective state jurisdiction which you have selected and apply for your license. Well, that was all about CPA.
Great. Thank you, Shreyans. So I think it was quite insightful, very comprehensive. I already have a lot of questions for you. So maybe I'll put up a few around CPA. So sure. One of the questions is easy. I think I could take that on your behalf. So is it, Lokesh asks, is it feasible to do CPA along with the job? The answer is yes. So Lokesh, all of us on the panel have been working with the industry or were working with the industry, and whatever additional certifications that we've got or additional degrees and diplomas we've got is along with the job. So CPA obviously, as Shreyans said, is not difficult. And I think a follow-up question for that is also that, is CPA more difficult than CA? So the answer is very simple. It is not. CA, according to me, I am a chartered accountant and CA is very close to my heart. It will always be. So there is no course in the world which is as difficult to crack as CA. So CPA is relatively easy. Shreyans, the other question that we have one question was, what is the number of years required for getting a license? So that's one of the questions that has been asked by Karan. And he also has one more question around Willys or Beckers. What is the preference?
So the experience requirement, generally, this again, experience requirement is very state to state. The different state boards, every state board has their respective licensing experience requirement, and which keeps from changing at times as well. So if you want to check the very recent requirement of the state which you have enrolled, because once you might have selected a state for giving examination. Now you can't change your state, so that state will remain the same for licensing as well. So in order to check the latest updates, I recommend you to go to the CPA licensing website of your specific state. But to on a generalized front, I can say to you, majority the requirement is of 1 to 2 years of experience in public accounting domain. That's a very generic requirement. Plus, if you are not doing any general public accounting, you can also show, demonstrate your industry experience as well. But there are few caveats and nuances, which again are state specific. So I recommend you to check that out on your respective state website. Regarding
Go ahead, Shreyans.
Okay, regarding Wiley and Becker, well, both of them are good brands to study with. How I generally advise students to go about is that both of them study materials offer free trial period to test their packages. They give you some complimentary free classes. I'll recommend go to their website, enroll yourself for those free classes and check it out. How is their faculty? How is their course material? And then make a decision, because it's very student specific. For instance, Wiley's study material, if you see, is very bulky, as you have your CA study material. So someone who is looking to deep dive very deep into the concept, Wiley has a very lengthy study material for you. Becker, on the other hand, it's a portal which includes books, coaching classes as well. It's very dynamic and your interface is very good. So it's break up into specific modules, small lectures, which are very handy in preparing at the time you are preparing for a various segments of CPA examination.
Sure. Thank you, Shreyans. So I think a couple of other questions, if I can quickly pick up. So there was one question from Ekansh, wherein he says that what are the benefits of doing CPA if you're already working as a chartered accountant, especially in the Big Four as well. So Ekansh, I have experience of working with the Big Four. So I Recently, quit the corporate world as an assistant director in EY, managing financial due diligence for the whole of the European market. So as Shreyans said, CA is recognized in India, and obviously Indian chartered accountants have moved out of India and kind of doing jobs there. But if you're wanting to pick up a job internationally, obviously CPA is one of the qualifications that makes you acceptable to larger corporates and even the smaller companies there. If you're working for a big four and if you're working across different service lines, so let's say you're working for assurance advisory or even for transactions, for example, M&A. And if you're a CPA, so obviously you get a global opportunity. So some of the engagements that happen, some of these engagements require a knowledge of the respective domain. So CPA equips you with that knowledge. Secondly, if you have some of these big fours also have elements wherein they send people out to international locations on permanent transfer or long-term transfer as well. So if you're planning for that kind of an opportunity as well, then CPA will add to the scope and it will make it easy for you to kind of maybe scout for such engagements and also get some of these engagements. So that is what answers your question. Now we've got some questions around how to select a state and what are the eligibility criteria. I think those are some elements that we would encourage you to maybe write to us or get in touch with us, because they will require a detailed understanding. So that's something that we will pick up on a one-on-one basis with participants who are interested. Shreyans, there was a question around in terms of where to take coaching. So Capit Solutions is your knowledge partner and provides coaching around CPA as well. So all courses that we're talking today, CAPEG has highly experienced faculties who have been running these courses, who've been teaching these courses. So if question, then CAPEG is the answer for you, right? Shreyans, there are also questions around comparative or between CPA Canada, Australia versus CPA US. So if I can take a stab at it and maybe you can add on to it. So CPA Canada and Australia are very specific to the respective countries. Obviously, they are equivalents of CPAs, but acceptability will be relatively less when you compare it to the CPA of the US, because I think that's the original CPA that we have. And obviously, with the new regulation that is changing, wherein CPA exams can be given sitting out of India, I think that gives a better advantage to anybody who's wanting to pursue CPA from the US. Shreyans, if there is anything else that you may want to add to it?
Very well summarized, Akhil. Just I want to add it from immigration front. Being an immigration advisor myself, I could share my experience in terms of why CPA, Canada and Australia came into picture. Is generally Indians, when they are looking for immigration, they are looking after Canada and Australia. And that's why many times I have been asked this question, if we want to apply for Canada, Australia, the CPA US comes into picture. Now, if your question is specifically with just respect to immigration for Canada and Australia, I would say that CPA USA is not being considered, or it doesn't add on to your point-based system for Canada and Australia. But CPA USA vis-a-vis Canada and Australia gives you a better advantage, because USA is worldwide recognized CPF, vis-a-vis Canada and Australia are respectively restricted to their specific country. And even if you talk about India, if you have done CPA USA, there are many job opportunities which can come up to you in India itself. But for CPA Canada and Australia, I can't say so.
Sure, and if I can just add on to career aspirations or opportunities, especially with the big fours. So a lot of these big fours have a lot of US-based clients. So a lot of their revenue or the workflow that comes into these big fours is coming in directly from the US. So if you are a CPA, obviously along with a CA or without even a CA, you get an added advantage because you already understand the nuances of the US market, especially in terms of regulations, audit and accounting as well. So the chance of you applying for a role in some of these assurance and advisory roles with the big fours and you getting selected based on the CPA are obviously much higher. So that is what I would say maybe from a CPA US perspective. But thank you, Shreyans. Thank you for those insights. I think they were wonderful. We already have a lot of questions, but I will still reiterate, we will share the contact details of CAPEG at the end of it. So if you are interested for any of these courses or have follow-up questions, do connect with us and we will have the respective faculties personally talk to you and answer some of those questions as well, right? Yeah. So at this point in time, I'll Yeah, Kamal, please go ahead.
Just to add that basis of feedback today, we'll be happy to organize a separate webinar very soon. Could be course specific. So ACCA, CAP, CPA will have a specific webinar where we'll answer all your queries. And then you can get more detailed knowledge about all of these courses.
Thank you. Thank you, Kamal. I think that was helpful. So Karan says that, can we make a WhatsApp group? Obviously we can. So maybe we'll create a WhatsApp group for all the participants who are registered for the session. I know some of the participants are having some technical glitch and not able to kind of get in. So we'll create that group and obviously share more details and happy to connect one-on-one as well, right? Okay, so at this point in time, I'll bring in Sana. So Sana is our ACCA guru. And people who do CA, so a course with 1C and 1A is difficult to crack. And Sana is creating a course which has two times C and A, obviously in the reverse direction. So Sana, if we can have you on video and maybe talk us through in terms of the ACCA course. Obviously, we know historically US and UK have been arch rivals. So Shreyans has done a good sales pitch of promoting CP. I think it's over to you. Share some nuggets around ACCA. So over to you, Sana.
Thanks, Akhil. Shreyans, it was actually a very insightful, detailed analysis of CPA. Now, when it comes to ACCA, ACCA is again a global qualification and it should not be missed out while considering the options. Doing CA is difficult. I think most of us knows this, that it's one of the very tough qualification across the world. But you can always do ACCA. It's comparatively much easier. ACCA is not a new organization. It is almost more than 100 years old organization. And it is based out of UK. And in India, it is gaining popularity in last 3 to 4 years only. So how are people are still confused as to why it is important for students or qualified Indian CAs to join ACCA? Let me just tell you that ACCA qualification is a very cost-effective way to gain knowledge and professionalism. The members not only gain technical knowledge in accounting and finance, but also gain valuable skills in organizational and strategic management. In India, ACCA students get placed easily in all the larger firms, big fours, and multinational companies. And it is not only in India, but in many other countries like Singapore, UK, UAE, Hong Kong, Malaysia, they get placed very easily. And it is one of the highly demanded by global employers. ACCA is really important and it opened avenues for jobs in more than 180 countries across the globe. So let me tell you that out of approximately 205 countries, it is recognized in more than 180 countries. So people used to think what we can do after joining this ACCA. If we talk about the career opportunities in ACCA, you can get into management consulting, business analyst, you can be in audit as well. Tax consulting is another option. Then treasury or cash management, forensic accounting, and financial reporting. So these are few options which you have if you have completed your ACCA. So now moving on to how to join this and what's the structure, how much time we take. So let me just give you a brief introduction of this qualification. ACCA is having three levels. One is, the first one is the applied knowledge level. Second one is applied skill level. And third one is strategic professional level. So, and it is the first, now we'll discuss each and every level in detail. When it comes to applied knowledge level, you can join this immediately after you qualify your school. So for only like if you have recently passed out class 12, you can start from knowledge level. Knowledge level has three subjects. One is accountant in business, management accounting, and financial accounting. So it's more towards accounting. Once you clear all these three papers, you will get diploma in accounting and finance. you know, this is the only qualification, not exactly the only one, but this is the qualification which gives a recognition after you complete your every level. As in, once you qualify this level, you will get one diploma. You'll get the diploma in accounting and finance. So you have something to add on to your CV. These three papers are purely MCQ based and can be attempted at any time during the year. There are some Pearson View centers. Aap wahan pe jaake ye exam kabhi bhi de sakte. It's all up to you. When you can prepare, just go and appear. Book your exam slot in advance, maybe 2-3 days in advance. Whenever you are prepared, go and appear for it. So once you finish this level, you can move on to the next level, which is called applied skill level. Applied skill level is having three subjects. It is having six subjects. Six subjects are corporate and business law, performance management, taxation, financial reporting, auditing and assurance, and financial management. So these six subjects, all these are computer-based papers. However, the first one, which is business law, you can appear for that paper at any point of time. It is again just like it was there in applied knowledge level. So rest all other papers for the next five papers, you have to go to the center. Exams are happening 4 times a year. Saal mein 4 baar exam hote hain. It happens in March, June, September, and December. In first week of these months, you have those exams. And results come in 1.5 months. For example, for March attempt, result was announced in mid of April. I think 2-3 days back, the result for SACA was announced. You can appear for even a single paper. Where one very important thing is that there is nothing like you have to appear in all paper at one time. Aap isme ek ek karke bhi paper de sakte. Once you finish this level, that is a skill level, you will get the advanced diploma in accounting and finance. So you will add something more into your CV. Another thing is, if you're a graduate and your university is recognized by ACCA, you can check for the exemption. You need not to start from knowledge level. You can start from skill level. If you're a graduate, then 4 papers are exempt if you have done BCom from a recognized university. Maybe if you are talking about Delhi University, yes, if you have done BCom from Delhi University, you can get exemption in 4 papers, like 3 papers of knowledge level and the first paper, that is business law of skill level. You just have to appear for the next 5 of this level. Another very good option which is available is, once you finish this BS, that skill level, you can opt for the BSc from Oxford Brookes University. You can appear, you just have to write one project and submit it there, and you can get this degree for BSc, which is an international qualification. So you'll get the dual advantage of doing ACC. Then moving on to the third level, the final level, which is called a strategic professional level. It is having 4 subjects. 2 are essential subjects, which everyone has to appear for. And for next 2, you have the option to choose from 4 papers. So when it comes to essential, there are 2 papers. First is a strategic business leader. And second one is strategic business reporting. Everyone has to appear for this. Then when it comes to optional papers, it's your choice. You can opt any 2 papers out of these 4. First is advanced financial management. Next is advanced performance management. Third is advanced taxation. Next is advanced audit and assurance. So if you are not interested in doing audit or tax, you can always go for financial management or performance management. One of the very good flexibility is that if you're not able to clear any one optional paper, then you can even choose the next one. It is not necessary that you have to appear for it. Once you have choose, you cannot go back. You can choose other ones as well. At professional level, these papers are paper-based examination. You have to go to the centers. Again, the paper will happen 4 times a year. You have to go to the center and write these exams. So once you finish all the 3 levels, you have to complete 1 ethics module, which is online. You can just log in online, pay the fees, take the exam, and it's done. And you also need 3 years of experience. Experience in the relevant finance function. It can be while you're pursuing this qualification, even the past experience will also come. For example, if you are a chartered accountant or pursuing CA, your articleship experience is counted in this. So once you finish all these things, you can apply for the membership of ACCA. Another important and tie-up they have is with University of London, which everyone knows that it is one of the top 10 universities across the world. Once you finish all the levels, you can go for MSc from University of London. You just have to write only 2 papers. You need not to go for the whole 2 years program or anything. You just have to write 2 papers and then you can get your MSc degree as well, and that too from University of London. So people are asking that how much time will it take to complete the qualification? It is completely up to you. How much time, if you talk from this perspective that how much time will generally a person take, it approximately take 2.5 years if you're starting from the knowledge level. Maximum 2.5 years because it is having 4 exams in a year and you have an option to choose only one at a time. And if you talk about just professional level, it will be completed in 1 year. So if you opt for 1 paper in, say, this upcoming June attempt, then next would be in September, December, and then next March. So in 1 year, it's done. And if you you want to do it quickly, you can always appear for 2 exams at a time and can finish it in just half of the year.
Sure, so I think... So Sana, I'll just barge in here because I see a lot of questions already coming in for AC. So I think while we share more information, let's pick up some questions and maybe those could help us sharing some of these questions. So Lokesh,
I'll just add on one thing.
Sure.
That if you are when we are talking about exemptions, if you are already a chartered accountant, you just have to appear for the professional level. You need not to go through the first or the second level. You just have to appear in 4 papers. Now we can take up all the questions which people are asking.
Sure, Sana. Thank you so much. So that was definitely insightful. So one question that has come in from Lokesh is, do Big Four sponsor ACC or CA? So Lokesh, the answer to that will be all Big Fours have their respective individual education policies. So if you're already working with a Big Four, you might want to reach out to your HR or L&D person and they'll be able to guide you. But generally speaking, from my experience, most of the Big Fours have some kind of sponsorship available for ACC as well as CPA, because these are courses that are relevant for them as well in terms of upskilling people. But you still may want to check it out. So the next question from Sunny is around BPP versus Kaplan. So I think it's a very similar answer to what Shreyans mentioned about Wiley's and Becker. So BPP very detailed and Kaplan still slightly abridged version of it. But if you enroll with the CAPEG for any one of these courses, obviously we bring in the best of both of these textbooks. And obviously that is when we impart learning. So one of the elements that I would want to call out here, because I've been a faculty with CAPEG for about 7+ years, is so all the courses that we teach or train students at CAPEG, so we bring in the best of all the curriculum that is available. The second element is, right from day one, the approach for coaching is application oriented, right? So one of the elements that you'll have to keep in mind is all these courses that we've picked up for conversations today focus heavily on application. None of them focus on the theoretical part of it. So that will be one key differentiator that we will have. Lokesh asks, diploma in IFRS versus ACCA. So Lokesh, there is actually no comparison. So ACCA is a full-blown degree. It gives you an edge over a lot of other things. Diploma in IFRS is only an add-on. So there are two types of certifications available in IFRS, and both of them are sponsored by ACCA. So one is diploma, which is a slightly detailed pen and paper exam, happens twice a year. And the other is certification, which is more of MCQs, again around IFRS, and you can do it at the convenience of your home. So I've done a certification in IFRS as well. It enhances your knowledge, but if you're looking at accelerating your career using diploma in IFRS or certification in IFRS, that will definitely not happen. Yeah. Okay, one last question before we move on to the next course. So ACCA is from UK, and UK also has the ICAEW. Who will be preferred? So if I can share my words of wisdom, and Sana can add to it. So ACCA, if you're picking up a course, so it is a combination of accounting or specialization in different fields, plus element of strategy as well, right? So if problem solving is an element that you want to kind of get into, if strategic decision making is what you want to get into through solving of simulation based case studies as questions in your exam, then ACCA is a preferred choice. And globally as well, when I look at people who come for interviews or people who apply for jobs, I see more of ACCAs globally applying for roles as compared to the ICAEWs. That's what I know of. And I think Sana or Shreyank, if you want to add something around ACCA.
One more question. Sorry to cut. I think one more question which has come up is that this ACCA has MOU with Australia and CPA Canada. Yes, they do have MOUs, and the detail of MOUs are available on the ACCA's official website. So you can anyway go through that, and the MOU details are available. Sorry.
That's
an
important point is with respect to, again, immigration. If UK is opening up its immigration policy from January 2021 onwards, which again will be point-based, similar to Canada and somewhat to Australia. Now, important part is that any immigration system has education as one of its important pillars. Now, if you have done an ACCA, that gives you a lot of points in UK immigration policy, which is very soon opening up.
Yes, someone asked about the fresher package. So the fresher package and everything depends on the skill set which you are possessing, what kind of experience you have. So it varies from starting from 6 to 8 lakhs to 20 lakhs if you complete your ACCA in one go and if you possess the right skills. And one question is, there's a tie-up with London School of Business and Finance that I have already answered that yes. No. I think it's different. There's a tie-up with London School of Business and Finance with ACCA. So when it comes to ACCA, ACCA has some recognized learning partners, and they are one of them. And CAPPAGE is also one of the recognized learning partner with ACCA.
Thank you, Sana. So I think in the interest of time, we will move on to the next course. So the next course is something that I'll talk about. So that's SIMA. It's Certified Institute of Management Accountants, and again, a course which is offered through UK. So if you are a graduate, if you are a student about to complete 12th, you can enroll for SIMA. If you're doing your graduation, you can do, if you're an MBA or a chartered accountant, you can do SIMA. So there are certain exemptions available. So how the SIMA curriculum is set up is, it focuses on building three unique skills as part of your professional journey. So one is, the first element is application. The second element is problem solving. And the third element is understanding of business and the business related elements, right? So if you are an MBA or a chartered accountant and you want to enroll for SIMA, so SIMA has four levels. It starts from the certificate level, the operational level, management level, and strategic level. Certificate level has four papers, and each of the other three levels, which is operational, management, and strategic, have two parts to it. So there are three papers which have three MCQ based exams. The passing percentage for each of these subjects is 70%. Once you complete each of these three objective exams in every level, then you appear for a case study, which is again a simulation based, computer based exam. The passing percentage for the case study is about 60%. Now, if you're an MBA or a chartered accountant, the certificate level and the operational level are completely exempt to you. From a management level, the objective exams are exempt for you. The only four exams that the only five exams you have to appear for is one is the case study for management level, the three objective exams for the strategic level, and the case study for strategic level exam. Now, if you are a student who's completing 12th and then wanting to pick up on a course which will open up global career opportunities, very similar to what the others we spoke about, so you can pick up SEMA along with your graduation. And then there are students, we've had students at CAPPAGE who've completed SEMA much before they've completed their graduation as well. Now, why does that happen? So you can appear for your objective exams whenever you are ready. So if you're ready today, you can appear for your exam tomorrow. So it's a real-time objective MCQ-based exam. So you go to the examination center, you appear for the exam, and you get your result instantly. As I said, 70% is the passing percentage. For case studies, the exams are held four times in a year. So they're held in February, May, August, and November every year. For each of the levels, so operational, management, and strategic, so first week of the respective month in the quarter, the operational exams are happening. In the second week, we have the management level, and in the final week, we have the strategic level. So you can choose any window between this entire week to kind of appear for your exams relating to SEMA. So if I just share some of my experience, so I did my CA way back in 2002. And since then, I was working till about 2010 doing different roles and everything was going well. But at some point in time, I realized that if I want to accelerate my professional journey, if I want to get into the table of the board of directors, or if I want to get onto the management table to be able to devise strategy for organizations, to devise to solve business problems, or even kind of write research papers or set up things like an innovation lab, I need the tools and techniques to be able to do that. So while I have experience to do that, but obviously I also need tools and techniques. So the SEMA curriculum is curated in a manner that it gives you all the relevant tools and techniques to solve business problems. And then obviously with the kind of curriculum and examination pattern that they've set up, it focuses a lot on application, right? So if I can share, any business generally has four distinct elements that they need to look at. So one is the business as a whole. The second is, if you are a leader and if you're looking for a leadership position, how do you look at the business as a leader in terms of decision making? The third element is, what are the technical concepts and experiential learning that you already have, which you can input to kind of solve some of these problems, right? So the first was business, the second is leadership, the third is technical. The fourth element is, whenever you look at a business as a leader and you try and solve or maybe leverage any potential opportunity available, there is always a people element to it, right? So the fourth key component when you appear for a SEMA case study is the people aspect of it. Now, when you're appearing for the SEMA exam, all of these four skills get tested. So obviously, it's not something that we learned in our CA or BCom that we have to draw diagrams or kind of go and explain those diagrams. It is more of applying those diagrams to the case study or the questions or the problems that we have. Now, one of the unique elements for SEMA is that for a case study especially, you get your case study. It's a simulated case study. You get that case study at least 5 to 6 weeks before your exam, right? So this case study comes to you in an email. So the scope of your study is limited to the case study, is limited to the company that comes to in case study, and is limited to the industry that is there in the case study. So you prepare for it. And then when you go for the examination center in the respective weeks, you will get about 3 to 4 questions. Each of these questions will be subjective questions focusing only on the case study that you have. And obviously the examiner will, the intent of the invigilator would be to understand how will you apply your techniques, your concepts and your experiences to solve some of these problems, right? So that's about SEMA. And again, four levels, if you are a graduate, postgraduate, or sorry, if you're a postgraduate or a chartered accountant, 2.5 levels are already exempt for you. And you only have to give 5 out of the 16 papers that are there in SEMA. Once you clear SEMA, you get a degree which is called CGMA. Now, why this degree, I would say, and because I'm doing the sales pitch for SEMA, is the best of all the courses that we've spoken about, is the fact that it is powered by two of the largest accounting bodies in the world. So it's powered by SEMA itself, and it is also powered by a CPA from the US. So if you're a CGMA, which is what you get once you've cleared your all levels of SEMA, global opportunities open up for you. A lot of management consulting, risk management, decision making, finance manager, CEO kind of roles open up when once you are a CGMA.
So a quick question, Akhil. A lot of times students ask us a simple question. Shall we go ahead with SEMA or ACCA? Which one is better? So how would you answer this question?
Okay, I think a good question. So if you're looking at specialization in a particular field, which is specific to the financial accounting concepts and elements, then I think ACCA is what I would recommend, because the ACCA, people who are CAs and ACCAs generally tend to get more deeper roles in the field of finance and accounting. So they might be more preferred when it comes to, let's say, the field of audit, when it comes to profiles like record to report or even order to cash, right? But if you're looking for roles which are more global in nature, which are more problem solving in nature, which are more decision making in nature, that is when you would opt for a SEMA course. So that is a key differentiator.
So there's a question from Lokesh who wants to understand that which combination is good along with CA when there's not like to move abroad. So I guess he wants to know whether he should do ACC or SEMA along with CA if he's having no plan to move outside.
Okay, so again, Lokesh, all courses are very dear to me. But if I can give an honest answer based on my experience, if you're already a CA, then I would recommend you should go for a SEMA rather than an ACCA, because you already have the accounting specialization available with you. I'm assuming you're a working professional, so you already have that experience. So my pick will be you should go for SEMA if you're already a chartered accountant.
My one more question on behalf of students would be that I think that if I'm an average student, I do not score too much in my academics. So do you think I'll be able to finish SEMA?
So Kamalji, the very simple answer to this is, so as I said, even if you're a student who just come out of 12th and you're doing your graduation, and obviously I am not an SRCC person, so I don't have a very strong academic percentage in terms of the 99s that students get these days. So anybody who's an average student and has an eye to, has an aptitude for problem solving or kind of disciplined learning in terms of understanding business, then SEMA is definitely a course that they can crack. The other thing I would want to add on is, especially in terms of our teaching methodology at CAPPAGE. So we curate students, we nurture students in terms of building the mindset that they have. So once we develop that mindset in terms of looking at the business overall, looking at problems and trying to find out solutions, I think academics is only an enabler which gives us those tools which then need to be applied. So that will be my pick on whether you can do SEMA. The answer is, long story short, yes.
So, Akhil, one more question for you from Sahil, that along with MBA, which do you think is the best combination, SEMA, CP, or ACC?
Okay, I think I look at also the inputs from the panel, but if I were to, so luckily with me, I'm a CA, I'm an MBA, and I'm a SEMA as well. Management gives you a lot of tools. It gives you a lot of global tools, but I think the curriculum that we have for SEMA. So again, one, it also depends upon your interest, right? So if you're looking at global opportunities, but very specifically in the field of accounting or regulations or audit, I think a better bet would be CPA. But if you're looking at broader roles, slightly more strategic roles, then I think you can choose anything between an ACCA or a SEMA. So I have done three of them. I've not done CPA, but I coach ACCA students as well. I've been doing that for 4+ years now. So ACCA, I think, is also doing a very good job in terms of bringing the problem-solving mindset to the curriculum. However, I would still say that it's still heavy on specialization in particular areas, whereas SEMA is more a generic. And so it's like, let me draw an analogy, right? So if you're a CEO of an organization, you will not be a specialist in a particular field. You will maybe look at inputs from a lot of specialists, and then using those inputs, you will try and solve business problems, right? So that's how I will look at a CPA, ACCA versus a SEMA. So all of them have a place in the organization, all of them have a place in the board of directors, but it's more of specialization, specialized inputs versus generalist understanding and taking decisions from a business standpoint.
Okay, Thank you, Phil. Shreyans and Sana, anything from your end to answer this particular question?
Yeah, so CPA, if you talk about it, like we generally compare it with CA and draw an analogy that it's just a science and accounting domain expertise which you get. But CPA is much more beyond just finance and accounting. There also the curriculum, if you see, is text, MCQs, and task-based simulations. Task-based simulation is all about real-life practical scenarios where you have to draw analysis, draw analogy, and then come up with a solution. So it gives you a decision-making strategic viewpoint as well. Besides, from next year onwards, CPA course is going to undergo a change as well, and it's going to incorporate data analytics field as well into it. So if considering data analytics is going to be the one of the very important courses in the future, CPA is going to somewhat integrate those kind of elements also into its curriculum.
Okay, I think one last course that we had for today, which we want to talk about. So a lot of students, and Kamalji, this is coming back to you. So a lot of students who I interact with, I have interest in the different aspects of audit, right? So be it statutory audit, internal audit, concurrent audit. So in India, if I can put it that way, so in India, audit is synonymous with being a chartered accountant, right? So if you're a chartered accountant, you get an entry ticket to being an auditor. But we have a lot of students and professionals who are not chartered accountant, but still want to develop careers in the field of audit, right? So we've all heard about this course, CIA, which is Certified Internal Auditor, which is from the US. So if you can help us understand how CIA as a course, what benefits it brings in, and how does it help professionals who are not CAs to develop careers in the field of auditing?
So over to you. When it comes to audit, it's a very exciting profession. I've been into audit profile myself for a very long time when I served the corporate. See, audit is something which is not just a fact-finding activity, but also enhances your skill set in terms of getting in-depth knowledge of that particular process. I have seen a lot of people who really wants to get into audit profession, but then the only constraint is that they are not chartered accountants. In every country, you have to be a chartered accountant, whatever name you may use for that particular country, in order to do external audit, which is also called statutory audit. But then, if you still want to make your career in audit profession, CIA is the best certification for you. So the full form of CIA is Certified Internal Auditor. Again, it's a US-based certification, but globally recognized. So you name the country, it is very well accepted. And again, CIA certification is very well in demand in all kind of industries, whether it is Big Four, banking, NBFC, or any other kind of company. The CIA is quite a lot in demand. So certification is something where, so I'll again give a quick facts about CIA certification. CIA is a three-part exam. So part one, part two, and part three. It's not necessary that you have to give part one first and then part three. It can be in any permutation combination. Though as a trainer, we always recommend that it has to be part one, two, and three. So the certification is specialization into internal audit. And the standards what we cover in this particular certification is the global auditing standards. So ISA is the word which we use, International Standards on Audit. Anyone who is a chartered accountant in the participants or part qualified may have studied Indian auditing standards. But when it comes to CIA, we do cover the International Standards on Audit. So it's a three-part examination. You don't need to give all three exams together. You can give it in any permutation combination. It's a center-based exam. You have to go to specific centers and give the exam. The passing percentage of this certification is also 75%. So if I'm giving part one today, there are about 100 plus questions. 75% is the passing score with no negative marking. Difficulty level, if I come to, it is not a difficult exam to crack. Basically, what is tested in certification is the basic concept of audit. So if you are clear with the concept, the certification is not difficult to handle. The examination can be given at any point of time. So again, it's an online on-demand exam, multiple choice question. You can select any part the way you want, and you don't need to give all three parts in single day. Right. So this is about CIE certification. If it comes to costing, the total costing to finish all three parts would be approximately 1 lakh rupees, which you don't need to shell out at one go. So you have to pay part wise. It includes the official fees as well as the study material and the coaching fees also. So that's a brief about certification. If we talk about career path, internal audit, most of the companies go for. It's a need for the company. So the difference between external and internal audit is, as a layman, if I have to compare, external audit is something which is mandatory. Companies have to do it, whether they like it or they won't. But internal audit is something which company wants to go for. It is about checking their own controls and where do they stand. So that's where you see more demand from all the companies. It's not just Big Four or specific industry who hire CIE, but also a lot of other companies, multinational Indian companies, and worldwide companies do hire CIE. Just to give you background, the body which governs the certification is called the IIA. It's again a US-based body. They have their own Indian chapter called the IIA India. Sana is heading the Delhi Women's Circle for the IIA as a president, and I'm part of the IIA Women's Circle as a secretary. So me and Sana both are trying to get more into the certification so that more people can get awareness about the certification. And also we would try to give them end-to-end solution. Also to add on, whatever courses we have discussed so far, be it CIMA, ACCA, CFE, CIE or CPA, we not only provide the coaching support, we also provide the placement support. So if I give my example, I left the corporate and started this company called CapEdge back in 2012. My idea was not just to start a coaching center, but the idea was to provide end-to-end solution to the candidate. We take a candidate, we train them, on industry standards. We try our best to give them practical knowledge rather than just giving them theoretical knowledge. And also, once the successfully completion is done for that particular course, we do have a very wide network of corporates where we refer our candidate for the jobs. We do not guarantee anything. We can never guarantee anything that we will give you a job. But we try our best to connect these two dots. Sana, anything you would like to discuss about CIE?
CIE is actually giving you an edge if you're already working in internal audit segment, because there is always a career path which anybody looks at. So if you have joined somewhere and want to go ahead take it to the next level, then CIA definitely helps you in giving the recognition and helps you in getting into it, that how you can move ahead in your career path in internal audit or maybe just the audit segment.
Sure, I think very valuable. Thank you, Sana, and thank you, Kamaljit, for sharing those. I'll pick up some questions that we have. So Shriram has a question that he's a PGDM. He worked in a BPO for about 3 years and he wants to settle in Canada. So his question is, would CPA Canada versus CPA USA, what will be beneficial? So I think taking a cue from what Shreyan said, so looking at the immigration policy of the respective country, points would be, so obviously you'll get more points if you're a CPA from Canada and want to settle in Canada. But obviously if you're looking for global opportunities, then CPA US will have more recognition. So I think given you've already made a choice in terms of settling in Canada, so CPA Canada is the right answer for you. Yeah. Okay. The second question I have from somebody named Home. What is the advantage a CPA can add, as I'm a practicing chartered accountant in India? So if I look at it, I will add two things to you. So if you're looking at adding on to your practice, US-based clients, especially in the field of audit, or accounting. So I think that is where CPA will add to your credentials and to the credibility of you and your firm. But if you're restricting yourself to practicing in India within Indian clients, I think the next element that you could get into is pick up CFE and try and get into the forensics field, because that's where a lot of chartered accountants with their strong technical accounting knowledge are getting into. So that would be my pick in terms of the answer. Riaz has a question, is coaching necessary for cracking CA exam? So Riaz, is it CA or is it some different course? Because unfortunately, at this point in time, CAPEG is not providing coaching around chartered CA. But for any other course, I would say the coaching is essential, not because we teach you the concept, but because we teach you the concepts in a way which can be applied into a particular situation, right? And I'll pick a very simple example. People who've already done their CAs or let's say BCOMs or MBAs as well, there are these basic frameworks available like Porter's Five Forces, BCGs, and all of these. Now, these are standalone frameworks available as a concept, right? But if you pick on any of these courses, be it CIA, ACCA, CPA, CIMA, or even CFE and CIA for that matter, all of these courses are focused on applying these concepts, right? So that application comes through, one, the teaching style. So we use a lot of case study-based examples to teach. And the second element, it comes through a lot of participation and discussion in the classrooms that we have. So you will be sitting with a group of students who will have different perspectives to a same, to the same point of view. But I think bringing all of them together and then seeing what is more relevant for the business, that's where coaching actually plays a very important role, especially in some of these niche courses, what I would say. And I will hand it over to Kamal to kind of add something more on behalf of how CAPEG can maybe add. And we promised at the start of the session, there are offers, exciting offers available for students. So Kamaljeet, over to you for the, so for solving the mystery for all of us.
Sure. And one quick question, I think somebody asked the package for CIA. So dear, it entirely depends on what level of career you are at, but I'm just giving you a pretty ballpark figure. If you start your career as a fresher, as CIA in India, assuming you have at least 2 to 3 years of work experience, be it internship or so on, your package will be roughly about 4 to 5 lakh to begin with. And it's just a ballpark number. It can be much higher than that. Entirely depends on your skill set and your negotiation level as well. Now, the very exciting part of this webinar is that first of all, I would like to thank all of you, all my speakers and all the participants who have joined this webinar and stayed with us till the end. So as promised, two very exciting things to offer. That if you want to join any of the courses which we have discussed today, CFE, CIA, ACCA or CIMA, and you register with us in next 48 hours starting from now, we shall be giving you 30% flat discount on the coaching fees. And that is something which is for all the courses. And the next exciting offer which I have to declare here is, here the timeline is still higher. If you have scored over 85% in your 12th class or in your graduation, we will give you either of the any of the courses which we have discussed today, the coaching for that particular course free of cost. We will be picking up 10 students for all these courses and the coaching will be free for you. When it comes to CIMA and ACCA, it's a complete degree. And the number of papers in CIMA is about 16, 17 paper and in ACCA, 13 paper. We'll be really happy to offer that. Anyways, we've been supporting the needy students quite a lot, as much as we can with a limited capacity. And this time, which is very testing time, we'll be really happy to offer free coaching for all these courses. But the only condition here is that you have, it's a merit base, right? So these are the details on the screen. You can share your mark sheets with us. You have 2 more weeks to go. We will be analyzing and we'll be picking up 10 best students merit based for these kind of offers. So anything else you want to know about these offers, these are the details. Please get in touch with us and recording of these webinars will be available. Anybody who has missed it, and these kind of contact details are there on your screen. So any questions you have related to offer or courses, please get in touch with us.
Great. So I think, thank you so much. Before we close the session, just a quick survey. So if you, I would like to understand from all the participants, especially who stayed on with us till the end, did you like the session? Was the session useful for you, helpful for you? If yes, please put a yes on chat, a why on chat. Even if it was not helpful, please put a an on chat. That will help us improve for future sessions.
In the meantime, I think Sriram has a question. So maybe Shreyans, if you can take it. He has some question related to CPL.
Yes, I think his question is, will the CPA exams be held in India going forward? Because he feels that he would want to enroll for it and complete that.
Well, Sriram, so I mentioned earlier as well that currently you can get CPA exam in India in the month of June and September only. Only these two windows have become open as of now. It's expected that more windows will open because due to COVID situation, American centers are closed as of now. So it might extend a bit, but no official communication as of now. And this arrangement is temporary, it's not permanent. So if you have prepped up, so June, September is something you can look for and save on your travel costs.
Thank you, Shreyans. And Akhil, I think if possible, can we have a group picture on this? I would request all of you to come and show your faces. We'll be happy to click a nice picture with all of us on board. All the participants, please switch it on. We'll be really happy to see you.
And Riaz, for your question, we will create a WhatsApp group for sure.
Okay. So all of you, please come on camp for one moment. We'll be happy to see everybody who's here with us. And not sure everybody is interested. Can I request once more? Would like to have a group picture. Consider this as a face-to-face training where we generally go and have a group picture. All right, so thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much for this session, and it was really at the same time, I'll just click on this picture as well. We have clicked pictures. Thank you so much. Thank you from all of us. And thank you so much, Akhil, Shreyans, Sana, to share such an insight on these courses. And guys, basis of feedback, we'll be really happy to connect with all of you on WhatsApp. A small request, that WhatsApp group will be entirely for the knowledge sharing. So kindly do not share any good morning, good evening, or anything related to the current problem. It's a humble request. And also, basis of feedback, we will be happy to organize a webinar for the specific course. Over to all of you. Anyone would like to interact? If any participant wants to interact, let me know. I can unmute quickly.
ये भावना नाम जप के संचय में कैसे बदल जाए, तो नाम जप में आ सकते हो इसके लिए तो एक ही विधि, नाम जप। आप जितना नाम जपें उतने ही नाम जपने में रुचि बढ़े।
So Karan, I don't think, I think you're on mute, and if you want to say something, please unmute yourself.
I think some background noise we have, which was
letting this is Sriram. Can you hear me?
Yeah, hi Sriram.
I think I have just able to get your insights from all your people who have been in this industry for the last 15, 20 years, I believe. I was able to get a lot of insights about what are the courses available apart from CPA as well, ACCA, CIA. I'm able to get more knowledge about other courses as well. But regarding the financial constraints, I want to pursue the CPA course, but still, I'm right now doing my articleship training here in India, in Chennai. So regarding the course which I posted earlier, CPA Canada, CPA US. Before that, they told me that we need to have a exposure in CPA. I mean, since it's an international course, I need to have exposure. If it is an Indian course, I have either go for CA, CW, or CS. I have an exposure in auditing field is more than enough. In this international course, I don't have any firms to look out for or any institute to go for coaching here, apart from the Miles or Symantec or Enterprise Time. I don't have CapEx solutions, which give me a more knowledge about this, all these stuffs. So moving further, to get all these more details, like tactical details, as I told, they are much more concentrating on application-oriented rather than theoretical part. So I want to get hands-on experience in this, either one of these international courses, in an internship or in training, so that it will be easy for my exams to apply real-time solutions, because all those are task-based simulations, which will be helpful for me to get an experience in this, any of the courses, especially CPA as well, I believe. So could you please guide me in this? Any CPA courses in Chennai or Hyderabad, Bangalore, and we need to relocate. So you should be helping me to grow this course.
Sure, Shriram. So if I can take that on behalf of the panel. So what we will do, Shriram, is I think we are on top of time for the session today. So we already have your contact details in terms of number and email if you've filled up that registration link. So a member from our team will get in touch with you to understand what are you exactly looking for and then explore in terms of how can we actively support you. So that will be my advice to you at this point in time.
Also, just to add, whatever courses we have discussed today, these are not just available in Delhi. These are available in online interactive mode and self-study mode. So it doesn't matter what is your location. You can always get in touch with us and get associated with us with any of these courses. So once again, thank you so much to everyone. Special thanks to all my lovely participants and the speakers, Akhil, Shreyans, and Sana. Thank you so much. And we will be really happy to see you once again. And you may share these news in all in your circle, the offers we have just disclosed. For the next webinar, we will be happy to see more people on board and interact with you. So thank you so much once again, all of you.
Thank you so much.
Stay safe. Thank you so much. And stay safe.
Thank you. Thank you so much, team.
Thank you.